There's nothing on the turn order.
Okay, I'm sorry. You said it was my turn?
Yes.
I mean, you said it was my turn. Sorry, I turned off my targeting computer and everything broke. Okay. I'm gonna punch that guy in the heart thing.
It's called his laser core.
I would like to attack his laser core.
Attack his laser core.
I remember how to do this. Hold on. Oh, and I get three attacks. I pull out my quarterstaff and I hit him. Did I hit him? Oh, I hit him so good.
Hold
right.
on, I'm reviewing.
It's a 20.
Yes. Yes, you did.
I hit him so good.
I
hit him again with my quarterstaff.
His defense is just 20.
Yeah, 20.
Alright, so first damage, 6. Second damage, 14. And then I'm gonna hit him with my clippity claws.
Guys, watch out!
Do you still have key points?
Figure it out. No, but I can always attack 3 because I'm a monk.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm on frost.
That's a bonus action.
Yeah, that.
15 hits.
Yeah,
everybody froze.
5 points of slashing damage as my claws come out and hit his red heart chest.
Yeah.
Get him.
And then it is
Duramon.
Duramon. That's his name. It's
Duramon. Duramon. Duramon.
Shh. Oh, fireballs! I'm almost out of spells.
We got it.
I will cast. I don't know how this is gonna work.
Are you casting escape?
I'm gonna throw up a line of acid on this guy.
Yikes.
Okay. Acid reflux.
What? A line of acid.
Oh, I get it.
I get it.
I was like, that's not in a pro. Okay.
I'm gonna throw up that. It's gonna like cross across. It's technically an area of effect, so I don't know if I just hit one of them or if I can hit more than one of them. But I'm gonna do an acid stream. This one.
Okay.
So can I hit more than one of the health bars? Or just
I'll say yeah. Yeah, you can. Because it's technically a sectional boss.
Mm.
Section.
Kind of like the couches.
Mm. You can put people on it.
I was going to say Power Rangers, but.
And rearrange them any way you want.
Couches was more adult. Good job.
Thanks.
No. Power just made more sense.
So whichever ones I hit, it's going to take 3d4 acid at the start of each of its turns.
Thank you.
Until it uses.
Is this macadamia nut?
Until it uses an action to. Oh, my saving throw is 15 for the DC.
Yeah, they keep failing.
Well, the third guy probably made it, though, right?
Do you have any bonuses? You got any pluses? Any minuses?
This is before I decided to give everyone bonuses.
All right.
Well,
the
cool.
Next part has even more bonuses.
You're a respectful DM.
In that case, each of those bubbles will take 3d4 damage at the start of their turn. Until they spin the rack to wash off that acid. And then he says, "Taste my bilious fury."
He sounds different.
All right, Rachel.
Why does he sound different?
He has a cold.
I shoot.
Alone.
That's right. Also, his voice hurt me. It hurt me right here.
Mm-hmm. That's your
larynx.
That's right.
No, I didn't hear that.
Also hits.
Okay, damage for the first. 11. Damage for the second.
Nice.
14.
Wow.
Shoot.
Except it's not 2 guns. It's my sword that I spin. I forgot that part.
Wait, are you spinning it as you're shooting?
Yeah, but it only shoots when it's aimed at the bad guy.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, so if I roll a 1, it means I Okay.
I've got a crazy tune.
So, remind me, these rocks that we are floating on, can we, like, control them in any way? No. Are they moving? No? Okay.
They're just floating.
Okay.
Try to jump to one.
Are there empty... There are other rocks floating around us, though?
Yes, but it would take, like an entire turn to jump from that.
Okay, and the rocks aren't like shifting at all.
No.
Okay.
Peppermint. Okay.
That's my turn. I just shoot twice. Pew pew. Okay. Pew
pew. Shotgun.
The club kill this guy.
One spoon, please.
Do 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 do. Do 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 do. Cock it. Kill.
Ah. Like, what is he doing?
Cloud kill.
You gave him those cloud kill bullets.
Range 120 feet.
Creature save.
Ruler thing.
Thomas, roll d20.
Yeah, that works. Okay.
No reason at all.
Go to my cool rolling thing. That's a 17. 17.
Oh my god. Why do I keep rolling threes?
You rolled like three threes.
Where do you want the poison damage to go?
Right in his hat! To the red
okay, ball. Roll me 5d8s.
Oh yeah. That sounds good.
I'm trusting Tom because I don't want to.
3, 4, 5.
You know you can just do this.
No, that's totally better.
I have a better range strategy.
You could just do that.
I don't know, maybe he's onto something. So that's 14 damage. Unless I added it wrong.
Maths is hard.
You're a banker, Abe.
That's why I added it right, probably.
Actually, you added 14. It to the point where you made it 14 when it's supposed to be...
Well, that's 10. Oh, it's 16. 16. Bank error.
You're banker. Yes,
you want to kill this guy or not?
Banker.
Shut it down.
Okay, my bad. The record screen is covering one of the twos.
Yeah.
My bad.
Maybe you should look into that pig farming.
Yeah, probably should. Also, it's really bothering me that everyone else has their icons down there but me.
You have to go to the chat window, and then at the bottom it says "as," and then you switch it over to Toxic Trees, or whatever his name is. Yeah, there it is.
Tree in the woods.
My bad.
Snim, you should do that.
I don't have a character to switch it to. I mean, I could be any of your characters.
No, don't be our characters. Whose turn is it?
There we go.
Are we killing this guy? Oh yeah.
Wrong one. Okay. I just keep clicking random things.
Bear would be like, okay. We kill this thing or not?
Do your job.
Say things like, come on, damn.
Wait, who are you trying to beat? Wait, I still have another attack.
Dave's
Japanese
turn.
People do
no,
not
I still
stereotype.
Have another attack. That
no,
was my
not
first
at
attack.
All.
Alright, it's my turn. I don't know if I cheated last time or what. But
how many attacks do you get?
How many
two.
Get?
Does he get two attacks with Cloud
one.
Kill?
I don't think so.
Wait. Is Cloud Kill a bullet that you gave him?
He gets another attack.
Yeah.
He's good to go.
Well, then he gets another attack. Hey, you
made
this.
I'm just going to load up my gun with some fire.
I take it away from him.
Just going to load up my gun with some fire.
Mm-hmm.
Shut it down!
Are you attacking with a fire?
No, it takes a turn to load up my gun.
Okay. So Tom loads up his gun with some fire and shuts it down.
Shut it down!
Put it down.
Alright. He's done now.
Alright. So, can I actually reach this thing with my hammers? Or can I tell my rock to move closer? Like,
get closer.
Come on, rock.
Move. Come on.
I mean, you could try.
Wait. Okay. I distinctly remember Liam saying we were close enough to hit. That's why I've been punching them.
Yeah, you were clawing it.
Yeah, you're close enough to hit.
Okay.
All right, well then, I'm going to do this all day.
All day, I'm going to use my hammers.
Jay, oh, do this all day, son.
Oh, all, right. All the hammers. This is one you can do all day.
All day. All
right. I'm going to use my hammers. I'm going to use Dolores first.
Thomas. Shh, shh,
shh. Dolores misses.
Nine does not hit.
I'm going to use my Betsy next.
Betsy.
Oh,
Betsy also does not
Dane,
hit.
Dane, what is...
I don't know, man. I don't know. D&D gods are against me.
Yeah, this week has been bad for you.
Yep.
Just throw away that dice, Dane. Throw it away.
Earn it.
Throw it away.
Change my color.
That'll fix it.
Change my color to poop brown.
I feel like maybe I should do this.
All right, that's it for me.
Which means it is Enemini turn.
Oh, wait, I can't. That doesn't work at all.
I know, that's the only thing. Like, I have a bunch of cool stuff that I can wear on my head, but... Headphones.
It will take 3d. Everything that failed to save will take 3d4 damage at the start of its turn. Should I roll it?
Okay.
Oh, I like
what about my poison damage?
Mm, mm-hmm.
Is there any poison effects to it?
I don't know. When does cloud kill happen?
It's up here.
So, you hear a loud screech come from the monster. And you see the light of its core go out.
Yeah. We took his core out.
We did it.
Hold on.
Yeah. Got him.
Adnan saw me.
It's not over yet. Oh, wrong one.
Over.
Leo doesn't have lasers to shoot us with anymore.
Yeah, but he's still got a sword.
Spoilers.
The guy on top of him.
Liam, so cloud kill happens when it first enters and also at the start of their turn. They have to make a constitution save or take 5d8 poison damage or half on a successful. Cloud kill. It's also moved 10 feet away in whatever direction you feel the clouds are moving.
He's failed.
Jeez. 5d8 damage, Tom.
This is not my dice.
Good roll, good roll.
Go roll, go roll.
Who's writing on the board?
Well, judging by the fact that Thomas P. is purple,
I can
probably was Dane.
That was me.
Yeah, definitely Dane.
Not sus at all, Tom.
Dad, you are going to get attacked.
Oh, poop. Are you sure?
Like, good attack or bad attack?
Oh, hey, watch out, guys!
I don't know.
Bad attack. I don't know what. Did you attack?
Is this 6 hit?
No! I parry it away. Like this!
Does it 75 hit?
Don't give the team ideas.
I will add all my enemies modifiers of whatever.
What? Liam, why is your face so small?
I didn't get to fix it.
That's just his face. He's got a small face. Why would you bring that up? Liam, does all three parts attack at once, or do they attack separately?
No, they attack like separately, but the arms didn't really have an attack.
Oh, okay.
They just stand there.
I mean, that's fine. I don't want to be attacked.
Is going to be Dad's turn, but as you ready your weapons to strike, some airships fly over you. They don't look like the ones from before, but they are black with a red stripe down the sides.
Okay.
And the two come and drop bombs on the boss.
Whoa! Wait, is that the bomb or the ship?
This thing. Kill it. Kill this thing. Kill it.
Tom, shh.
kill it.
Okay, let me read the rest.
What's the green?
As one of these ships fly by each of you, the doors open on each side. You see a masked figure look at you. Though the mask is more of an orange helmet. Here, take these. The soldier shouts. You see a potion of some sort fall into your hands with the label that reads Life Cure. Cure.
Alright. Is it my turn? Can I down that thing?
It's almost your turn. I have to move the other stuff.
Oh.
All your faces are in the way.
Don't judge. My face is nice. Nash fish.
My mountain dew.
Nash fish. Sorry if you hear like two things. It's because I couldn't mute.
You couldn't mute what?
My guy.
Oh. Okay.
Good talk.
Alright, now it is Dad's turn.
To take a full action to, yes, Thomas?
No.
What's the life cure? How many do we have?
You have one.
We all got one, right?
Okay.
It, like, restores everything. All your spell slots, all your key points, mana, you'll learn about later, but...
Before I drink this, we all have a ship that rolled up beside us and gave us one?
No, they just, like, flew over you.
But, like, we all got a potion.
Yeah, you all got a potion.
Oh, okay. Because I don't want to steal the one potion. I'd give it to the spellcaster. Yeah, then I'm gonna drink this random potion a stranger gave me. And I down this potion of randomness.
It's called a potion. It's called a life cure.
He didn't have time to explain it to me. He just said, hey, take this. And I was like, okay, buddy. You seem like a swell guy. I'm gonna drink it.
Okay. You gain all your key points, all your spells, all your HP back.
Oh.
What do you even know?
It's called a life cure.
I have 17 health.
Yeah, magic. And then I can still attack?
Yeah.
I'm gonna punch the guy that Tom marked kill.
Guys, I feel really great!
Is he the green or the blue?
I'm gonna do like a flying donkey kick. It's probably a thing.
So like backwards, two legs?
Yes, I'm gonna do two of those.
Those both fit. Are you attacking each part?
It's my bad.
Oh, that one. Yeah. So there was the core, two arms, and the dude.
No, it was just the arms are each piece.
So how many pieces are there to attack?
Three.
Three arms.
Technically two, but there's two arms right now.
Alright, then I'm going to attack one of the arms.
Okay.
And I do 6 points of damage, and then I'm going to spend a key point, and I'm going to do Stunning Strike. So you got to make
I thought you did 12 damages.
Well, yeah, 12 altogether, but I did two sixes.
Okay.
And then I'm going to use Stunning Strike, so he's got to make a Constitution save.
Okay.
Come on.
And what's the save that I'm supposed to hit?
13.
Okay.
Good.
Alright, whatever arm I just attacked is not
stunned. Well, hold up. Sorry. Whoa, Liam, are you adding his actual constitution to that roll?
Because you should.
Oh,
so
Liam.
12 plus his constitution modifier.
So if he even has a +1 to constitution, he's
succeeded. He saved.
Two.
Liam, don't forget about Andy's wild magic roll thing.
Yeah.
Mm.
Wild magic.
And then I'm gonna offhand it.
Okay.
Just don't forget about it.
With my claw attack.
That hits.
Watch out! That arm is really fast.
And that's my turn.
Kill
the killer. thing. Kill.
I would like to drink this potion first.
There he is.
You got there.
May I still cast a spell, or did that take my action?
No, you can still cast a spell.
Unbridled fury will flow through my veins.
I will
turn it down a notch.
I thought it was great.
I will, I would like to quicken a spell.
Tom, is that what your guy sounds like?
No.
Okay.
No. I drink this potion.
I drink it now.
Alright,
Tom.
I'm going to drink the potion. When it's my turn.
Yeah, hold, I guess? No. What do you do? Fireball.
Fireball.
So I'm going to need a dexterity saving throw.
Difficulty class 15.
I love seeing that.
One.
Yeah, minus five dex. That's not good.
He's a big dude.
He's a big dude. All right, so he's going to suffer. He's going to suffer. What are you going to suffer? Cast a level 3. Submit. 35!
Wow.
That's a good roll. That's three sixes.
What?
Is that each perk?
Yep.
Yay.
So that was my bonus action. Because I clicked into that. And then I will cast...
Wow.
That was mine, Sliver.
Noise.
I need to make an intelligence saving throw.
Remember to add his modifier.
That's right.
There you go.
That's a good roll.
Not very wicked smart.
So nothing happens with that.
Okay.
And that's wicked smart.
That is my turn.
Wicked smart.
Okay.
That's great. A good turn.
Okay. I am going to. I'm not going to drink my potion yet. I'm still in decent shape. Almost save it. I'm going to aim at the guy on the top of the thing.
The kill guy.
Twice.
With the kill on it, because that's who you need to kill.
The 19 hit.
Whoever is dying that, dead. Just
19 does hit.
The 17 hit.
Yes, 17 hits.
11 damage. Pew, pew, pew. I think... what do I have in my inventory? No, I think... Okay. I think that's it. That's all I got. I shoot, and then I say...
Adios.
Does anyone need an extra potion? And then I shoot. That's it.
Oh, I mean, I don't need the potion, but selfishly, me as a person wants the potion.
I want it.
Okay, I'll Thomas, it. Your turn.
Oh, snap. Okay, so
I mean,
I have a question.
You are closest to Rachel.
Liam, does the potion...
You your own potion yet.
Does the potion get me my thunder back? My blue lightning?
I need your advice! I need it now.
I'm picturing him as like this tiny little dragonborn.
Give me your
that advice. Voice.
Give it now.
Shooting his guns off all the time.
Say hello to me.
Say hello to me.
Let's say yes. Yes. Okay. Yes, it would.
Hit it. And now let's do my blue lightning. Blue lightning. Okay. 5 by 30 feet. Yeah, it's good.
It's a line, too.
I want to attack this guy. I want to attack this guy up there. So I want to... Okay. So, ruler. Okay.
Oh, 5 excuse by 30. Me. Excuse me.
That does.
Well, so Liam has said that we are close enough to hit with melee range. The question becomes, Liam, would a 30-foot line from where he is hit all of the monster? Because you said it was a pretty big monster.
Yeah.
So it hits all of them. All right, so then I believe they have to make a DC save, Tom?
DC save, yeah. And then do I roll?
Well, you got to see if they hit or not. And then...
11.
Let me pull out my player's handbook.
I want to.
It looks like I added a 1. Hold on. Slash.
Alright, so you're a what color? A blue?
Yeah, he's a blue.
You're gonna do 2d6 damage.
Okay. I feel like it hits automatic.
Yes, but if he saves, then it takes half.
So then what does he have to roll?
Sometimes she does.
100. 100 plus.
Liam, you're going to make a saving throw. You're going to make
DC 11. Elements,
dexterity, strength.
It under it, it has blue lightning DC, then 11. So yeah, Liam, you just did it.
Actually, Thomas, that says DC 15.
It would be 8 plus his constitution plus proficiency. It literally just says, oh, I'm sorry, dex saving throw. What is happening, Tom?
It's Thomas moving his character everywhere.
Did you catch that, Liam? Dexterity saving throw. Thomas, we talked about this. Stop.
Seven.
Okay, so now you take 2d6 damage, Tom. Tom, please sit.
Me?
Yeah, so you don't fall off and rip the computer down.
Okay.
You have to roll the... damage.
Okay. 1d100 or 1d20?
It's 2d6.
Okay. 1, 2, 5.
Okay. Is that your turn? Oh, wait. Is that for everything? I forgot.
So, did I do 6 damage?
You did 5 damage. Yes, you did.
That did absolutely nothing. It doesn't look like the bars went down. It bought.
Maybe it just wasn't, super, super powerful, but,
Remember, we're not fighting bars. We're fighting a monster.
Yeah.
Anything else you're doing, Thomas?
I know something I'm doing, because I failed you, Liam.
You did one job.
Music!
One job.
First, Liam, did drinking the potion take an action?
Good question.
No.
Okay, then I fireball him with my gun.
This is a crazy gun.
He's a spellcasting
on D6 damage.
He's Gene Starwin.
Yes, that's totally not what I based this character off of.
It's called 5, 6. 6 damage. Do I ever roll if it hits?
No.
1d20. Still gotta do it anyways. 12.
It's instant hit. It's fireball.
6. Damage. 6 damage.
I think it's 66 with its fireball, isn't it?
Healing something called fire throw.
Oh, that's right. Yeah,
fire throw.
It's fire.
3d6.
6 damage.
That. I mean, that's cool.
I want to attack this guy, though.
Thomas, you've used up both of your attack actions.
No, I'm attacking this guy with fire throw. Yeah. them.
Oh.
Him.
Well, you already did.
Deal damage.
I already did.
Good.
Are you done with your turn?
Yeah.
Okay. It is Dane's turn after 10 minutes.
Alright, let's see here. I think we're gonna throw another hammer in the mix. I'm gonna cast Spiritual Weapon.
Oh, yeah.
And I'm gonna cast it at third level. So, that would be, Alright, it's gonna make a melee attack. Using the melee spell attack. How do you do that? 5. Oh, okay. Let's see here. We'll do one of those, plus one of these. We're going to roll it. Didn't hit. 9 seems to be my favorite number tonight. I don't know why. Just cursed with nines. Cursed
man.
With nine.
Maybe you should roll it.
So, my spiritual hammer is hanging out up there. So, can you put that up there?
It keeps putting this one.
All right, and then I'm gonna attack with my attack action, since that was my bonus action to cast that. And that is under here. So here's Dolores. Dolores, what the heck? See, that's bug, right? That's the 5th 9 I've rolled tonight.
Somebody just drew a hammer over that. Did you try rolling something not 9?
Let me try. Hold on.
Have you tried just rolling the dice?
There. That was better.
Wow.
Thanks, Addy.
Nicely
Thanks
done.
For the advice. Rolled something not 9.
You sure did.
Nailed it.
All right. I flubbed it. So who else? Whose turn is it? Flubbed them all. It was a triple flub.
Dane, you are going to be attacked.
If it's from the right arm, he gets stunned.
Honestly, it's probably for the best.
I rolled better than a 9.
I'll at least have contributed something.
Tom, stop writing on the board.
You said 8? Yeah. 8, it does not hit me.
Okay. Well, then I think that wraps up his turn.
Too bad he wasn't aiming for you. He's aiming for the rock.
It is tree.
Yeah,
tree and the woods.
Did I notice that the body didn't attack because it was stunned?
Yeah.
I'm gonna punch it again.
And by punch, I'm gonna use my quarterstaff.
Can I jump off this rock?
Yes, but it would take your entire turn to jump to another rock.
Oh, I don't want to jump on the rock. I want to jump on him.
You can't Oh, wait.
Or can you?
You could jump on him.
Oh, I'm jumping.
It's all in the dice.
It's all in the dice.
Hey, guys! I'm coming!
I'm gonna roll. 22.
Oh, wait, I forgot. That was the laser. Yeah. Okay, you can land on him.
You're rolling rocks tonight, Donnie.
I wanna be up here.
Okay.
Well, then you'll get advantage on attack rolls against that guy.
Heck yeah! But you said that took my turn, right?
Yes.
In case you guys wanted, there's now a vacant rock. Dane, if maybe you need to get, I don't know, closer, different angle. Mine doesn't roll nines.
Alright.
That's my turn.
Oh, yeah. Hammers.
Okay. It is Andy's turn.
Stop sending memes.
I would like to... Well, I don't remember what any of these things do.
Fireball.
Shut up, Rhythm.
Don't you yell at Rhythm.
Too loud.
I'm going to cast Thunder Wave. No, maybe I shouldn't cast Thunder Wave. Well, I don't know. I'm casting Thunderwave.
Aim it at Abe.
At level two. I mean, I didn't put you up there, man.
Hey, it's all right, man. I chose casting this. Thunderwave
at level two. You chose this. I'm going to spend one to make it a careful spell, so you automatically make your saving throw.
Oh, heck yeah.
Okay. I can do that.
That's for me, not you, Liam.
Oh, that's lame damage, though.
3 damage?
Well, it's going to be a total of 9 damage, but you save, so you get half damage. So you get 4.
Okay.
So the boss needs to make Constitution saving throw! Or take 9 damage. All of it. I think it made
17.
It. 17. Plus stuff, I'm sure. Yeah.
Round that up, Dane.
Killing it up. So then.
I'm targeting both. Targeting both the.
I'm gonna savor it. Both true the... culinarian.
God, it's so gross.
Both of the shields, the remaining health bars, are gonna take either 9 damage on if they fail their save, or 4 damage if they make their save.
Okay. So I have to roll them again.
What?
So I have to roll again?
No.
Okay. So they...
Yep, so, be,
so it would take 9 damage, but halve?
Oh. Yeah, it's like 4.
Well, I rolled a 17. Is that...
Oh, yeah, I made it. And he will yell... The power of the ancients flows through my veins. That's my turn.
Are you gonna yell after all your spells?
Yes.
Okay. Just didn't know what to prepare for.
All
right. A lark. I am gonna
shoot
at the guy on top again.
Yeah, she's still up.
Oh, it's louder. Sorry.
Probably not hit.
I feel like this is a fake Sephiroth boss battle, because I hear the selecting.
So it's either 12 or 14 hit?
Both hit.
Oh! I deal 12 and 12 damage. Pew pew!
Whoever is selecting stuff on the... battle menu, please stop.
It's just happening. I'm sorry. I'll pick another music.
Has anybody seen Bob?
Where's Bob?
He's right dead.
Okay. Rachel, right there. Anything else you're doing on your turn?
I wear my purple thing.
Okay.
Just,
it yep. is shotgun.
Boom, boom.
Ow, Eric. Headbang.
Thomas, it is your turn.
Okay.
There we go.
Can do stuff out.
Sorry, Lena. I'm gonna go to
Ocean's Fury. So 1d20.
Oh yeah, I forgot you guys found that sword in the back of a non-fire truck.
3 hit.
3 does not hit.
Definitely hit.
You should come up on the back with me.
Because it can hit. Nope.
No.
Definitely hit. Yeah.
That's my turn. Thomas.
Okay, I'm gonna scream at him. I'm gonna scream at him and say. You get poop head.
You heard him.
You get poop head. And that's my turn.
So he's gonna take 3d4 damage.
From getting shot.
No, from getting insulted.
Oh.
And another half goes down.
Wow. You're insulted more damage than my second level spell.
Yep. Word well, can hurt.
Call him a poop.
We can cut to the bone.
Wow.
Alright. Dane, you got your floaty hammer.
Dane didn't do any damage yet. Alright, let's see here. Alright, hey, hammer, go hit that guy.
Alright.
Sephiroth! How that? Did I hit him?
yeah, 13 hits him.
Alright.
I'm glad you decided to, try not to roll nine this time.
One would say you even succeeded.
That's gonna be 12 damage. And then, here come my hammers.
What's their names? Phyllis and Bertha?
No, Dolores and Betsy.
Got it.
Right.
Betsy! Here goes Dolores.
Oh, Dolores! I love you. That's Dolores' damage. Here comes Betsy.
Betsy! Aww.
I don't think Betsy hit.
Aw, poor Betsy.
Yeah, poor Betsy.
You know, Dolores! All right,
Go green! Yeah!
And then for my movement, I'm gonna jump 76 feet over this one.
Bob's there! You can't jump there, Bob is!
I don't think Bob's there.
Hey, Bob. I honestly think Thomas has a point with Bob being there.
Alright. That's it for me.
Which means is weapon's turn. And he is going to try to, like, smack away someone.
Is it me?
Mandy, roll me a dex save.
Alright, BRB.
I'm really good at those.
Is that a lie?
That would be a boss.
You take 7 damage and you get smacked along onto this other rock.
Oh, I just put Bob there.
I am so glad this rock is here to catch my fall.
What did the five fingers say to Duramon? Slap!
And then it is Dad's turn, but he is AFK.
Oh, he would take 3d4 damage again at the start of his turn.
Oh, yeah.
Covered in acid. But since I got smacked, I'm going to have to make a constitution saving throw. And I fail, so my acid is gone. So next turn, starting next turn, he has no more acid on him. Oh yeah, he would take that damage this turn.
Sorry, I'm back.
It's your turn, Dad. And you got smacked onto another rock.
Smackaroo.
I'm going to punch that guy that isn't Sephiroth in the face.
He's not. Well, he's technically. You don't know, for sure.
You don't know.
If I can't hit him, who can I hit?
Everything.
Alright. I'm going to hit.
Everything.
I'm going to hit with my quarterstaff twice. And you told me I had advantage. Everything. So a 23 and a 17.
Yeah, they both hit.
I'm gonna do my claws and a nat 20.
Yeah, that's
a critical hit.
All hits. Oh, it's a lot better than those nines, Dane. But Dane is rolling.
And then I'm gonna do a stunning strike to whoever I'm attacking.
From the DM.
Hammers and nines, those are my thing.
So you have to roll a Constitution save. That's what I'm doing. DC 13.
It's like PG 13, but better.
Yeah. I'm a Kung Fu.
You sure you're not just being the Kung Fu Master?
18. And no, I did not just pull that out of my butt. I did a GM roll so no one could see it.
I'm going to spend a key point for that. Bloop. Bloop, bloop. And you know what, for the Googles, I'm going to spend another key point because I can do it on every attack. So I do it one more time. I stole some cheese from my wife.
Liam, if you make a DM roll, can you make a rolling noise in the future? Yeah. So we know that you're doing it. That's pretty good, actually. Yeah.
It totally does not sound like the Yu-Gi-Oh! Life Point counter.
you sold it.
Alright, did he make the second one?
I did not see the next roll.
Oh, I'm forcing him to do it twice.
Oh.
I can do it on every hit, I like to roll my attacks first.
15.
Son of a... Everything's great!
Guys! Help me up here!
Did you attack twice?
I attacked three times.
Alright. Nat one.
Oh, the second time was a nat one. Mm-hmm. Oh, then he is stunned until the end of my next turn.
Oh. How much damage?
Alright. Andy.
So stun isn't about damage. Stun's about stunning people. So stun, Tom Finn.
I would like to... Stun's bad.
Yeah, it means they automatically fail dex and attack. Dex and strength rolls. And attack rolls against the creature has advantage.
Can you spell the fury of the chromatic dragons?
Yeah, kind of.
And he's going to hold one nostril and just like... Shoot one big loop of acid.
Ew!
Man, the yelling, but that's, I can't deal with that.
Acid splash, so...
In your nose?
They need to make a... Oh, I hit. Wait, do I actually roll an attack roll? How does this spell work?
Click it in the thing, we'll all read it together.
Dexterity saving throw.
Hey, was that a tiny fork?
No, this
I automatically fail those.
Oh,
it's my,
cool.
It's my martini olive thing. It's an
owl. I gotcha.
Yeah.
Nice.
I mean, yes, it's a tiny fork.
You suffer eight acid people.
I like to eat my cheese with a tiny little fork.
Tiniest of tiny forks.
That's my turn.
Okay.
Eat acid.
Rachel.
You're just acid-ing all over this guy.
So much acid.
Copper dragons.
So I get advantage on attacks, ranged attacks?
Yes.
Sweet. Pew-pew!
Bang.
Sweet. Bang, bang. Bang.
Does a 13 hit?
Yes.
11 damage.
How do you do it?
Oh! I...
Pew-pew!
Yeah. I take my gun, my sword, and I... Like... aim for a long time, and I like crouch, and I aim, and then I go, whoo, and I spin it, and I shoot.
Okay. So, Dad, you are going to jump back onto the rock, because you know this
slow
thing
fall.
Is going to fall.
Can you slow fall in space?
I can slow fall anywhere I want. I'm a monk.
You have to have a wall to slow fall on.
No, I'm a monk.
So, you all...
Technical.
You all get a weapon for beating this thing.
Oh,
what? Usually break a part of it off.
If it's not a hammer, I'm not interested.
We just take his sword away. He doesn't need it. Just take
this guy just full of weapons like a pinata? Whoa!
You get that.
Weapon pinata. Hammer of the stars.
I want his heart!
Rachel or Tom, which one of you prefer gun?
What kind of gun?
Like actual guns.
Oh.
I like guns because my character's meant to use guns.
I believe I need the gun.
I'll take it!
This is my gun.
Nobody else.
Oh! Death Prowler. Attack 4d4 plus 1.
Whoa.
It seems to have 5 slots in it.
Giving out trade secrets over there.
Yeah. Demonic stat. Oh, I probably shouldn't say that.
Pretty cool gun.
Look at all these slots for orbs.
The what are you getting? I'm not getting anything.
Hold on, it's kind of...
I'm trying to find something that...
You'll just have to wait.
My gun has a gold chip. Anybody want weapons?
That's all right. I think mine was on the top. That's why I came out first.
Can I? Does it have like a bandana? More melons?
Trees in the Woods is just jumping across all the rocks, looking at everyone else's stuff.
Okay. Liam, what happens? What happens when we...
I can't move my gun.
I'm handing out the items. Dad, this...
I can't move my gun.
Okay.
Billy's still there. Dad, you missed Billy.
Oh, Billy.
Old Billy's over here. I'm just Sam over here. Oh, Billy.
Hammer said that he lost it to time.
Liam, do those show up in my inventory? How does this work?
You have to go in and copy the damage.
Oh, I can do that. I can do that.
Rachel, I did not prepare, so I am.
Fine, I have like 8 swords I picked up.
Don't worry, I have a extra weapon just floating around.
Yeah, I made a macro, Liam.
I don't know what a macro means.
It means I can just hit a button and then you'll get my roll. But I put a label on it so you know what
Rachel,
it is.
You get this.
Ooh. Oh. Oh no.
Why are you saying oh no? Okay. So, after the demon falls to the ground, your rocks all float to the ground. You've won. You suddenly realize that the guy on top, Luca Oresco, has snuck away. In the distance, you hear a, hey, you. Yeah, you there. I need to talk to you.
Hey, listen! I will...
You all get dropped here, and you see a pirate right in front of you. I don't know if we want to...
Cool, a pirate!
Right now. Okay.
Yeah, I want to talk to this pirate guy.
Don't worry, guys! I talk pirate!
So you all get those new weapons now, especially yours, Rachel. I am super excited about those. I spent a lot of time on.
So much time.
What does mine do?
Many things.
Tom.
So like the life force thing, is that like a healing thing?
No, that's a damage.
Okay, so it, like, shoots energy.
Why do you think the name is so ominous?
I don't know. I'll find out.
You'll find out next time you fight something.
Ominous. Right.
We gotta get some music in here, Dad.
All right, I got you.
Noah, would be good?
Yep, I'm ready. What?
Oh, it's kind of copyrighted.
Can't use hashtag copyright music for Dungeons & Dragons.
I was going to say PTC, but that's copyrighted.
Against the rules.
What the hell is PTC? Paper.
Pirates of the Caribbean.
Oh.
That probably wouldn't be appropriate for
this. What?
Sorry, I let them listen to it.
Okay.
Pirates of the World!
All right, I got you, Liam. I got you. Continue.
Okay, so you all see this pirate in front of you by a ship. He's not at all kind of sus.
He's out here buying ships, huh?
But there's also... Oh, I have a new notebook for this one. Okay. You find yourself in the fishing port of Bostein. It has many stores, but sadly, all of them are in lockdown, with many Dagon soldiers stationed outside of them. Except for one, it's a big tent that looks like it may have what you want.
Oh.
Come on, guys!
I think we should go to that big tent over there.
I'm just gonna...
Oh, there it is.
Sneak over here.
Why are you putting yourself on his ship?
Yeah, I'm gonna look what's there.
How do I do that? How do I move? How do I do the movement thing again?
You have to make sure you're on select move.
I got it.
And then
I got
you
it.
Grab yourself and then Q.
A lot of movement, but I'm here. I'm going to the tent.
You're fast. Wow.
Okay, I figured it out. Figure guns.
Inside.
Hey, you got something we want?
Yeah, tent.
I'm a tent.
You guys going in the tent?
Yeah.
Wait, where's the tent at? Oh, yeah.
Okay, come on, guys. I've got a whole lot of... I don't have any money.
Oh, yeah, you gave it to that guy who gave Andy a stick.
I'm sure it'll come in handy.
Hey, Jeremiah. You want this potion for next time we get in a big fight?
Yes.
Okay, I give you my
potion. Of course, I can use the put the most use into it, as my spells are all powerful.
Jeremiah, I'm really glad you got your voice back.
See, I don't need it because I got guns. When I fire like 8 times in the air.
Wait, I got guns too, ready? Right.
And I turn around and I go,
pew 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 pew!
And a bolt of energy flies from my finger.
Whoa, crap. Rock. Oh.
Dad, you're nowhere close to us.
It does 2 damage to a rock.
Pew pew!
Dad, you're nowhere close to us.
Right, potion of life gear.
Nobody's gonna attack in the wizard.
Hey, Liam.
What?
I'm gonna poke a nearby stick, a nearby, like, rock on the beach with my new staff.
Okay. Roll me a GM D20.
I did it.
Okay, so those of you going in there, that's the shop list. Uno momento, por favor.
Wait, where's the shop list? Did I see something? Am I missing something? I can't afford anything anyways.
Okay, so... Andy, it just takes 3d10 damage, and you
Do I kill the rock?
Andy, you take 2 damage from it. You feel as if it's sucking your life force.
Oh, snap.
The life force thing's not good. Not a good thing. Ugh. Oh. Ow.
there, I think I sent it to you all.
Oh, there we go. Okay, so some health potions.
Okay, so, you think to yourself, what would a tent merchant be doing here? As you walk into the dark and foreboding tent, the owner is, you can't tell what race he is. He's wearing dark robes that shade their face. Welcome to my tent, my dear customer. You worry about what you've gotten yourself into. You take a look at their wares. At least they're good. Rhythm, I love Pirates of the Caribbean, so I have to turn you down.
You gotta turn them down, man.
We're going to go shopping.
Well, we had money. I spent it all.
Dad, I'm over
no,
up where you
guys,
are.
Some of you still have money. I think Rachel still has all of it.
No, you guys bought guns at the very beginning, didn't you?
I have 50
no, Rachel
copper,
didn't buy it.
Says, but I feel like I don't know why I would have 50 copper. Did I put it in the wrong spot? Should I have 50 gold instead of 50 copper?
I don't know, man.
You have 50 gold.
Do I have 50 gold?
Yeah, you got 50 gold at the beginning.
Oh, alright. I should put it in the copper slot. Copper. Who tracks copper? It's like counting your pennies.
Damn, what are you doing?
Plus 15 armor class?
Wait, what?
What, the dragon scale armor? Oh, this bounty hunter only.
Oh, yeah, plus 15 makes the armor class 25?
Does anybody else?
Are you sure you're gonna do that?
I'm downstairs.
I can hear you.
Okay. Apparently we're not bounty hunters though.
Oh no.
There is also the Fail of Galandriel.
The Vial of Galandriel.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that looks really pretty.
Oh. Hey, do you mean sphere or spear?
Fail.
Vial? Because if it's a 20-foot spear, I will sell everything I have right now to get it.
Yeah, it's a 20-foot spear.
Shines light in a 20-foot spear. Wow.
It's a very sharp piece of light.
So, Liam, there's armor and there are the robes. The robes are super cheap but have a better AC. Is that accurate?
Yeah, but you can't afford them yet, but you're also a bounty hunter, Rachel.
I don't have 100 gold.
That's why I said you can't afford them yet, but...
Oh, but I mean, I could get dark black robes.
Yeah.
Do you want 74 gold
for super cheap? Yeah. And I mean,
copper.
Hey, do you want 74 gold?
Thomas just came in my room and waved at me. It was weird.
What's the leather armor? Leather armor's like what? Plus 20? Plus 2?
Yeah. Leather armor sets your armor class at plus 1 or 11.
So Liam, you're saying that if my current armor class is 15. And I wear these robes, I'll be at a 21?
Yeah.
That's what you're saying.
You sure about this?
Yeah. So
it's super cheap, Liam.
So, yeah, Liam, the reason we're asking is that it's going to be really hard for any monsters to hit us if that's the case.
Yeah.
Which is okay with us, but you might not have very much fun with it.
I mean, you could do like...
Set it.
Maybe like a plus 1. And even then, that's super cheap.
Yep, even then, that's super cheap.
Yeah, because leather armor, how much should I pay for my
leather armor? Leather armor only gives a plus 1.
Yeah, leather armor is a plus 1, and it costs...
Yeah, plus 5 is a lot of AC.
I think this is the same 5 minutes of Pirates of the Caribbean, just on loop.
I think so, too.
For an hour, and then I looped it.
The best part. I like it when it loops. It's really, really cool.
I go into the tent and I say, "Your armor looks amazing!" And I drop 50 gold on the counter and buy 5 armors.
The Dagon?
Yeah.
Is it because that one's the better one now?
It's because... Well, yeah, because I can afford 5 of them. And I give everyone Dagon armor.
Well, Dagon is also the enemy. Of mine.
Oh, so now we're looking like the enemies?
Yeah, we look like enemies.
Yeah.
Is this like, are these cursed items? Is that why they're so cheap? Are we gonna put them on a turn?
Oh my god.
It's fine. It's not
I
made this thing like the black market or anything.
Yeah, I buy 5 Dagon armors, and I say, hey, put on this armor, everyone.
I mean, okay. Not really my fit.
I'm not proficient with armor. I don't think I can wear it.
Oh, okay.
He can buy the dark black robes. They cover his face.
Oh, yeah.
Robes. No, I'm good.
Okay, who can wear armor?
I cannot.
I can wear armor.
I don't think I can either.
I have 10 now.
What are the stats on these armor?
I buy 3 armors.
Are they plus 5 or plus 1?
Plus 5, it says.
The AC.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, I buy. Wait, can Tom wear armor? Tom's a wizard. Tom can't wear armor.
Do I put the dagger armor over my regular armor? How does it work? Or is it just 5 AC?
It's just normal armor.
Okay.
Okay, I buy 2 armors and I give 1 to.
No for me.
Hammering.
All right, I'll put it on.
I'm gonna wear my dagger armor. Now I look like a bad guy.
Oh, that's a pretty sweet robe. Look at that robe.
How much is it?
Rachel just bought you one, I think.
Well, I want one.
Yeah, I'll buy robes. Who wants robes?
Me! You I only got $20.
She only bought three, though.
Yeah, so I bought two armors for 20 gold.
I think my chainmail might be a
little
better.
I think only two of us can wear armor. Is your chainmail better?
Hold on. I think I got 20 GP. I got enough.
Okay.
I can buy my
chainmail.
Hey, so this dagger armor is plus 5 to AC.
Yeah, I don't know that I understand. Is because like chainmail is 16 AC.
So could I put it on top of your
dexterity
modifier plus 10 plus dex plus 5?
Yeah, so I think my chainmail is better by 1.
Okay.
If I understand it correctly.
So Liam, for the dag on armor, if I have a dex modifier of 3, for my AC, do I get 10 plus 3 plus 5, or is it just 10 plus
5. No, you switch out the armor for the dagon.
Yeah, but I mean, my dex modifier is 3. So do I get that with my AC as well, or is it just... Well, I'm adding that 5 to
Stop.
For the dagon armor.
So, Liam, usually when you have armor, it's your... It starts at a base 8 plus your constitution. No, dexterity. Then plus whatever the modifier of the armor. So in this case, Rachel's saying, is that plus 5 going to like the normal ability, or is this plus 5 to something else?
It's plus 5 to your normal AC.
Okay, so then I would assume your
8 plus
whatever. 10 plus, yeah.
Okay. 10, so I'm at 18.
Where are we? Anyone else worried? Curious?
So some more people walk into
robe.
The tent. They're all wearing the dark black robes.
Oh. Do I need to buy a robe now? I'm concerned.
No.
Yeah, you're nowhere close to it. I come back in.
I come in.
To buy the robe.
I mean, I'm not gonna look good anyways. I feel like I am a rather large.
You said you wanted the fail of Bond Drill.
Yeah, I can't afford it though. I'm broke.
Why did you give that old man all your money?
Money
I think
is
I,
worthless.
I don't know. I don't have much money either. I only have 45 copper. Can I get buy like a candy bar with that?
Duramon puts a pouch full of gold coins on the counter and says, "Treat yourselves to the generosity of the dragons!" And he walks out.
Wow, dude, that's really generous.
I mean, I guess I'll take a black robe.
It's 74 gold, so...
Ooh!
Dispense it amongst yourselves.
I mean, maybe it's a good idea if we all wear armor. I think
so.
The DM's trying to tell us something, so I'm gonna get
a
black armor.
I'm not telling you anything.
I bought a black robe
and
I put it on.
I just wanted to make everyone feel suspicious of these random characters.
I
feel
suspicious.
Yep. I already
I'm gonna
do,
buy the file of Galadriel without asking any questions.
Dark black robe.
I roll a shotgun.
Not on his shotgun butt. I mean, are you guys
one
gonna
file.
End up talking to the pirate?
No.
Yeah, kind of like looking at us, groping all the stuff. I thought,
well,
yeah, I thought we.
Is shopping.
Where's the pirate? I thought we were in
He's
the pirate.
By the pirate ship.
I think it was just like, hey, we're like, oh wait.
I guess I'll go talk to that lonely pirate.
All right, we're almost done here, I think.
You should take the excess money.
Huh?
Oh, I guess I've been up here by this pirate the whole time.
Hey, buddy, what are you doing?
I'm looking for someone to share in an adventure.
That's great!
I'm willing to pay whoever joins.
Uh-huh!
Oh, Rachel, I know you were really excited about the Golden Glory, but, Sid's nowhere to be seen.
Yeah.
Hey guys, yeah. This guy wants to pay you some money. I told him it doesn't really matter.
Okay. I'll join.
Is there glory to be had?
Well, we do get to find a lost treasure.
I'm in.
Heal.
You know what? I'm already here, so why not?
And I shoot my death fury into the air.
I know he's gonna do that.
Tom.
Thomas. It's called death penalty, not death fury.
I don't know.
Death fury is just weird. Okay, so you all in?
I mean,
yeah.
Okay.
So, he shows you all the way onto his pirate ship, and then you all get on there.
This is a nice pirate ship. Is this blood?
Is this the fore or the aft?
It's like there's some blood.
That's just the bow.
I think this is the starboard.
I think you're right.
I go and barf off the ship.
Yeah, if this was real life, I'd be hurling over the side. Apparently I get seasickness.
Remember when you guys caught all those fish, though?
Yep, I don't, because I was passed out. Because of seasickness.
I'm fine, but above. Okay.
So, Rachel.
This guy right here will just...
Are you still holder of the Sword of Heroes?
Oh, snap.
Yeah.
Good.
I thought he's third on the ground.
Oh, Rachel.
I'm at the prow. I'm at the prow.
Why are you there?
I'm king of the worlding.
Are you like Titanic?
What's the difference between a prow and a bow?
Prow's where you prow people.
Prow is the portion of the ship's bow that's above the water. So I guess we're all on the prow. She's on the bow of the prow, though.
Bow on the prow of the ship in the middle of the sea?
Pa-pow!
Rachel.
Yeah. Bow, prow, wow.
The pirate looks at you and says, "You there, hand me that magic sword."
No, this is my sword. I worked hard for this sword.
How do you know you have a sword?
This is all my bark.
Whoa, Thomas!
Stop! What if I were to say I know that sword's true potential?
Well, then I'd say tell me, but I'm not gonna give it to you.
What if I told you you had to give it to me in order to find it?
Hold on. The Sword of Heroes. Are you a hero?
Rachel is over here. Pirates over here.
It's cool, we're shouting.
I mean...
You guys can be a lot closer.
Down a pirate.
That's what you do on a boat. Shout.
No.
Look at me, I'm supposed to be
first of all, who are you? And what do you know about the sword?
I know everything about the sword. I know the man who forged it, origin, everything. And I even know the man who sent you to get it.
What's his name?
Sid Kane. That was his name of the man who sent you to get it.
Oh. Alright.
I'm just over here firing the cannon.
Tom, stop coloring on the board.
My name is Hargan Kane.
Oh man, they're like brothers. Or fathers. Sisters, maybe.
Sid Kane is my son.
Oh.
Oh, it's pretty close!
And this
That's
man
what happens when
me.
We assume.
And this man next to me is my grandson. My granddaughter is below deck, working on her machine.
What's her name?
Hannah Kane.
Oh, you're all a bunch of Canes.
Rachel, if you recall, Hargan Kane is actually a name in the bounty hunter history.
Oh,
snap.
We got backstories.
What do I know about?
He was actually one of the most well-known bounty hunters.
Oh. Swam back up here. And I'm good.
So I feel like you're playing like shuffleboard.
Now I'm just firing the cannon.
Okay, Tom.
He was actually one of the most well-known bounty hunters. He went on a lot of quests, saved a lot of people, and he was actually one of the few people that made bounty hunting popular.
Oh, I just remembered who you are. Yeah, you can have this sword. Take it.
Excellent.
That's a real big change of pace.
That was quick.
He's gonna betray us and kill us all.
Anyways, I think it's only the bow if you're outside the ship. I think when you're on the ship, it's the fore.
I went to back to bar thing.
You know that treasure I was telling you people about?
Yeah.
This sword is the key to the treasure.
Oh, I probably need it back then.
He puts it on his back.
Well, I thought you were gonna give it back to her. What do you do here?
I thought this wasn't keepsies.
Were you gonna like make it magic or something?
With pirates.
I mean, he's got a point there. I think you should have known when you gave it to him you were dealing with pirates.
Yeah, we got duped.
First bounty hunter that ever lived.
Wait, is he a pirate or bounty hunter?
Is he a pirate bounty hunter?
He could be.
I just like
so cool.
flop down on this table here.
Is this your map?
Yes. How do you think I keep my ship afloat?
Listen, don't make him mad. He could, like, kill all of us with the snap of his fingers.
Well, he definitely can now that he gave him that sword.
Anyone want a melon?
And I pull one off my necklace and just start eating.
So where are we going?
I just go back adventure. And immediately barf.
You can do that with this man.
Well, whatever treasure you are searching for, I am in, because there's going to be so much glory. I can tell everyone that I worked with you.
This guy sounds like he's pretty cool. Sounds like he knows some cool things. Where are we going?
We are going to an abandoned isle. That is all I can really tell you.
That's pretty mysterious.
All should head below deck to get some rest.
Yeah,
I will inform you about the details at dinner.
Are the crew quarters in the fore or the aft?
What?
Never mind.
You're a pirate. You should. Okay.
I've been many things, but I'm old.
I'm just still barfing, and there's like a bit of barf on the deck.
Gross. Pirate bounty hunter. Pretty
I'm
cool
gonna
combo.
Take a nap before dinner.
What?
I'm gonna go take a nap before dinner. I'm tired from the fight.
I will also nap.
I'm gonna shoot off my last finger gun.
And
then I'm gonna do that too.
So is everyone going below deck?
No, I'm still gonna barf.
You're a fancy.
Because they do not want barf all over the bottom deck.
I'm going.
There's a toilet down here, Tom.
Barf. Oh, are you
is there a toilet
picture
down
not...
there? Is there a toilet down there, Lim?
I'm seeing
also,
a galley.
Tom, Lim, why did you draw a person in the ocean?
He's swimming.
I don't think
so. Because he wants to swim away, but he doesn't know how.
I want to swim away, but I don't know how.
Oh, look at that.
I go to the pirate.
Whoa,
and
a ship
ask,
in the
is
ship.
There,
and a tank.
I'm trying to ask him something.
Okay, sorry, I got excited.
I ask the pirate captain, I would say he's the captain, is there a toilet on the bottom deck?
I would say yes, there is.
The bucket?
It's not a bucket, it's a very high end ship.
They call that a commode.
And then I immediately run to the bottom deck. Wherever it is.
Tree in the Woods is just gonna, like, go in a circle for a moment and then just, like, flop down and pass out, like, sprawled on the floor.
I'll rest on this couch over here.
That's me when I'm down under there. Just gotta go back.
I'm not gonna say anything. You guys probably already saw it.
I don't see anything.
I mean, I saw stuff, but my character only saw the first room. I just plopped down on the floor.
Mm-hmm. I don't know where.
Andy,
I don't see
are you
anything.
Going below deck?
I'm
too.
Below deck.
Yes.
I go sleep on the couch.
Pasta.
Do I get to go down there too? I want to go down.
Yeah, you said you went down. Give him a moment, he's bringing us.
I have to add everyone back into the player.
Right oh! There. Nice! Okay, where's that? Okay.
So it's a pretty nice ship for how it looked. Above deck?
Finger guns.
This is a weird music. It makes me think it's raining.
Wait, you mean the background?
Yeah, the background music. It makes me think it's raining. Alright. So you all are on the...
Not me,
deck.
I went to the bathroom.
Thomas is in the bathroom. Three of you are passed out. Andy, what are you up to?
I'm just barfing in the towel lot.
Andy, you're muted. Andy, you're muted.
What?
Can we go rest?
Okay.
And while I'm barfing, I get tired and pass out.
I put on some relaxation music for us all.
Nice.
Oh wait, yeah. DM
magic. I think I need to buy a rain stick. We need more rain sticks in my life.
I think you do need a rain stick.
Like, I just start limping around, trying not to fall asleep. And then, if anybody's in the hallway, I go into the hallway and pass out. So,
you all take a long rest until you all get called for dinner.
You had me at long rest.
Oh, I'm not gonna eat anything or I will just explode with all the barf.
Maybe it's a magical ship and you don't feel sick anymore inside.
I mean, the dude is literally a bounty hunter pirate. Anything is possible in this world.
Like you do. Oh, thank you for taking the door. I did not.
Instead of going like this.
Alright, so we're on the most famous bounty hunter pirate ever. This is his grandson. His daughter?
I'm going to say
granddaughter.
Granddaughter's working on an experiment.
Granddaughter, grandson.
And we're going after Noah. And Sid was the son.
Yeah, Sid was the son.
That's a fire hydrant.
Okay. I'm following.
You know, Lim, he's just sitting off to the side.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. I like that. How'd you do that?
Magic.
Also landed 32 many pairs.
You were called to dinner.
I was sleeping on the couch.
Gosh. Come on.
I hear the dinner bell, Rachel.
He rang the bell. We have to fight on rocks.
You guys just see me. Oh, did he go to fix the toilet?
No, he's actually like cooking dinner.
Oh, he hasn't come out yet.
Yeah, he's like preparing it.
So how about this pirate guy?
You guys just see me
pirate bounty hunter.
You guys just see me just sit pretty much like just start leaning to side to side and then just face plant on the table and pass out.
He's tired. So what do we know about this guy? Should we be concerned?
What do you know about him, Nene? Is he
the greatest bounty hunter that ever lived, made the profession popular.
But how? What did he do?
I don't really know. I just know he's like super famous.
His grandson just sits up and put his fist on the table.
Oh, hey, I forgot you're here.
We're so ignorant.
Hey, we didn't mean to.
Several dragons. He brought peace.
You just hear from me.
He brought peace to many cities and did other stuff.
Yeah, it's pretty much what I said.
Hey, man, didn't mean to insult your granddaddy. He seems like a pretty cool guy.
I totally forgot you were there.
So,
hey, grandson, what's your name?
Tom.
Call me Leon.
Leon, what's this treasure we're looking for?
He hasn't told anyone much about it.
Not even you guys?
Yeah, all I really do is help out around the ship with maps and stuff. And he teaches me a bit of the way of the sword here and there.
Do you know how long it's going to take to get there?
I don't know, a couple hours, days, months.
Wait, what? See, days or
you
months?
You guys just see my chair start to lean and then just bonk to the ground.
Oh, there he goes.
I'm gonna carry him to the bedroom.
So, you all see Hannah holding like this tablet type thing, and then she looks up at you and goes, "You guys must be pretty famous bounty, hired guns, right?"
Oh yeah, we're super famous.
I'm not.
We've done a few things. Yes.
You guys must have heard of a rat pad, right?
What?
Yeah.
I grew up in an ice park.
No, I haven't heard of that.
Well, it's this thing that all, like, hired guns and people use. It's got, like, everything on it. It keeps track of all your missions that you've completed. And like everything.
It's called a what now? A bread pan?
A rep pad.
Oh. Rep
Here,
pad.
I can give you guys one. All I need is a team.
I lost mine somewhere.
Oh, we need a team name, guys. How about Bushes in the Forest?
You guys get up and like, what happened?
Grass coming up with a team in name. The path.
How about the Glorious
and
gang.
You guys just see me plop down to the ground again.
Guns of Glory.
How about Keepers of the Blade?
Snails in the Cold.
Duramon's Defilers.
Keepers of the Glory.
Mountains that Shed. No.
The Holy Hammers.
Hammers of glory. Hammers and guns of glory. Hammers and guns
hammers,
and
guns,
of
swords,
glory.
And magic.
Hammers.
Hammer and team. I'm just saying that.
Hey, excuse me, miss. Can we see that rep pad? I'm going to write a few of these down.
Soils of the earth and mud. Dust. Cold. Melons. Tasty fruit.
What are mud, I a sweet acronym?
Melon, tasty fruit.
What's your
that one's kind of long.
Trees, is that your name, Abe?
Well, people call me Trees. My real name is Tree in the Woods. From the great background of the owlbears.
I can't find my history.
How about Duratree right. Hammer and Nay Nay? Shotgun!
How about TDNHS?
I like it. It's got
it's
some
like
rhythm
I
to
sneezed.
It.
I bless you.
TTNHS. TTNHS.
I nailed it.
Bless
you. So I'll put you all down for TDNHS.
I mean, it's probably as good as it's going to get. Yeah, put working title.
Can you put it in quotes?
What is that, calligraphy? So what else did you say was on this rep pad?
And she puts the rep pad on the table.
Oh, look! I know how to use this.
Oh, and I hit a couple of buttons and then shrug and put it back down.
Lim, that's
that sounds like a scoreboard. Look at this.
Lim, that's a Pokédex.
Here's us. We're at the bottom.
TM Magic.
Where?
With
right
the
here.
Pad,
TBNHS.
With the rep pad, you can see your ranking and where you stand on all the other completed jobs and
one job,
bounty
one star.
Stuff.
Single star job. Wait, did we finish a job? I think that was
the
big guy.
Yeah,
the
intro mission counted as a job.
Oh, okay. We're amazing.
And also,
so,
your completed jobs.
What,
you guys
what's
just
the...
see me get up and shoot a ball.
Whoa, grandkid. You've done more jobs than your grandfather?
That's probably why he's so salty.
Whoa!
He's old, what can I say?
Ooh, and he's cocky too.
Oh, you gotta be kind to your elders, son.
Say, what do you get when you move up in rankings on this thing?
You guys just see me get up and...
Just like bragging rights or something?
Sorta. You get to be known as better, soldiers.
For jobs, I bet.
I'm a monk.
Yeah, you get more reputation.
Can I get more inner peace?
Sure, it can cause inner peace.
Okay, I'm game. Cause I'm great, and my gifts are meant to be shared with the world.
So, anybody know what's for dinner? Oh!
Oh! Just then, Hargan walks in, and he puts stuff, puts the food on the table.
All right.
It looks like he's serving a ham with a little bit of salad on the side.
Oh, ham! I'll eat it.
My character is just sitting through the wall, but he's actually not. He's barfing.
Okay, Tom, we get it.
Just sitting in that wall.
I'm gonna eat until there's literally no food left.
Is he even gonna ask where I am?
Nope.
You're probably fine. You took a nap, and then you vomited some more. How many bathrooms does this ship have?
I don't know.
It's got an office? Like, let me look around here. It's a nice ship. And a tank.
I mean, it's even got a... No, that's just... That's
a tank.
Just, it's not... So you've got a mech.
That is a tank.
So, we're going to an island, and we're looking for a treasure. And there's a sword, and that guy's your... child's child, and that's a girl. What are we doing here?
How do I put this?
The right way.
The island up ahead is is full of challenges and puzzles. I need you all to help me complete those puzzles and get the treasure.
I like puzzles.
I need to go.
No one really knows what the treasure is.
Okay,
people only know that it exists.
We kind of ran into some puzzles on our last job and didn't do too great at them. Are you sure you want us?
I'm pretty smart.
Yeah, I guess you were. You guys figured it out. All right.
You gotta find the inner peace.
Always been good at hammering things out. My name. Hammering. Get it? Ow.
And then he puts this orb on the table.
Oh, snap. Is it called corruption? Wait, we may not know that. I'm sorry.
This here is what I call a summoning gem.
Hmm.
It is a very rare gem, and it can only be used with items that have slots. It is what it's called for short.
With what slots? Sorry, my headset cut out.
Oh, man.
Weapons with slots.
Oh, so I can put that in this hammer. I'm going to put my hammer on the table.
So, you have found the ancient weapons of demonic.
Yeah, wait, what?
I'm sure it's fine. It's probably fine.
Yeah, one of mine's real evil, and she holds up two swords, and one's like white and glowing and pure. The other one's like black, twisted metal with all the light into it.
I don't know about that. I don't know about that one on the left.
Mine killed me.
What?
No, it didn't kill you. It just sucked some of your life out.
What did I say, Stan? Oh,
that's not nearly as bad.
My words stand.
Well, my hammer just looks like it's been lost to time.
I just got this ring that lets me do this.
I shoot another magic missile at the chair.
Whoa, holy... Whoa! Wow!
But it's only when I go pew pew pew! Otherwise it doesn't do anything.
You're telling me, if I take this here orb, I'm gonna hold up the orb. I put it in this...
Just a suggestion.
Yeah.
Oh god.
We'll it might be better if you put it with a magic user.
Maybe.
Oh, okay. So, if Duramon picked up this orb, and I'm gonna pick up the orb, and he put it in his life-sucking rod over here. Theoretically, I'm gonna put it in his in one of the slots in his life-sucking rod. What would happen?
It wouldn't do much. It would just summon the creature trapped inside the orb.
Oh, that's it?
Oh, that's it.
What's trapped inside it?
No one really knows.
Well, let's
this
summon it.
This is one of the rarest summons.
I summoned it.
Okay.
Oh. I feel like this is poor gender manners.
It doesn't really do much.
Yeah.
And then he puts another item on the table.
I slam my staff into the ground and try to summon the creature.
No, he puts five more items on the table.
Oh,
that
what
look
are...
like wrist straps.
I won't.
I don't think this is working.
These are mana.
Try wiggling it around.
They hold your mana. Mana is what you need for spells.
I start tapping my sword on the.
You guys just need to come back.
Duramon, you might want to listen to what he's saying here. It might be pertinent to that.
He's and giving away straps.
And I just grab one of these straps, and I'm like. What's this? And I've.
Do they
my
like
chair just goes,
snap
oh.
on our wrist?
It's a mana.
And my chair just falls backwards.
It's like a wrist strap. Like, imagine a Pokemon Mega Ring, but not exactly a Pokemon Mega Ring, because this is D&D.
I know what it is.
Got it.
Well, I'm picturing a snap bracelet, so that's what I'm going to go with.
So, this holds our mana, and we need mana to summon these things?
Yes.
Do all orbs summon things?
Yes, they are all summon orbs.
Whoa.
But there are few orbs that are just normal orbs.
Ah, sounds like my kind of orb. Nothing fancy.
I didn't get an orb.
I'm going to be too showy with my orbs. I'm going to take a wrist strap and put it on my wrist.
Yeah, I already snapped mine on.
I take
yeah,
a wrist strap.
So you guys get...
100
mana.
What? You put it on your ankle, Rachel. It would be called an ankle
can I
strap.
Can I summon like right now?
No, because Andy took that.
And Andy has it.
Mana. I have 100 mana.
Too slow.
All the mana.
So this so orb Andy, that's if, on my screen I don't need.
If you put the orb in your staff.
Done.
That's. That means you have five more slots for that. So, are you going to test it out right now?
Oh man,
cost me mana. I've been trying, but it's been failing.
Did you put your wrist strap on?
Not yet. I do now.
Snap.
Now. Now that you have the wrist strap, you should try the summon.
I mean, is it safe to do that? This is a very confined vessel.
She's safe. I've done this type of stuff multiple times.
But have you done it in the interior of your boat?
I feel like that's a valid question.
Should we be up top on the poop deck? That's what it's called, I think.
No, it's just fine to do it in here. I have insurance.
Oh, that's good.
That's very responsible of you.
You seem like a really responsible adult.
Alright, Andy, you gonna do this?
I don't know, now that everyone's paying attention, I'm gonna throw my one stick.
Come on, man, just summon the thing already.
Do it for the dragon people, that's what you are.
I didn't realize there was limited uses. I only have 100 mana.
I've got 102. No.
You can have some of mine.
Eventually, you
Does
can
that
regain
work? That thing.
I slid my staff under the table.
Does anyone still have a life cure?
It still is not working.
No. I do. Does that restore mana?
Andy has one.
I also have one.
Yes. That life cure that you hold there is able to restore 100 mana.
Whoa!
How much mana does it cost to summon the thing?
It depends on the orb.
Okay.
Corruption takes 5 mana.
Oh, that's not too bad.
That's like 1,000 uses!
So, Andy, are you going to test out the orb?
Okay.
I'm gonna do it.
Okay.
Peer pressure.
Just gonna summon a demi spell and the entire.
Well, then,
ship
if you implodes. Summon it, you have to roll a D100.
Sure.
Oh, yeah. Roll that D100.
How much we take?
So.
Instant dead.
Everyone watches Andy look different. Than what he normally does.
He looks so different.
His eyes turn a different color and his skin is darker.
Oh, what? Whoa! Look at that!
Andy, you have your character gets pushed down into the back of his mind and you get controlled by another being.
Oh,
makes sense.
And totally fine. Right now, with the 61, you cast Madness on yourself.
And you have failed. Also, you guys just see my cheeks go up and run.
Oh,
and
geez.
We run to the bathroom.
So what should we be worried about this?
There's nothing to worry about.
To the pirate.
See, sounds fine.
Andy, your character is not actually being controlled by Duramon. He's being controlled by another, like, being.
What is this other being's motivations?
I have to read the full corruption effect.
Time out.
I forgot
about
all the comedy
in here. It's not good when the DM starts to laugh. We're already dead.
So your character, the other being's alignment is neutral evil. So yeah. Oh, and for an hour, you know how to read, speak, and write corrupt.
Corrupt.
Yeah.
Everything's fine, guys.
Whoa! Sound a lot different.
I don't know what you're talking about. Everything's fine.
Oh, alright.
Anyone else freak it out?
That spell I gave you all is called the corruption. If you are not careful enough, it will corrupt you all.
See, I feel like you should have told us that before we started putting it in our things.
How do we know if we're corrupt?
I'm not corrupt, you're corrupt.
Here are the signs of corruption. A corrupt being. One of their arms becomes pure darkness.
I'm going to look over at
Look
Duramon.
At his arm!
Is his arm pure darkness?
No.
Oh,
okay.
All right.
Their heart will They will become a different person. Their heart will become lost in darkness.
Oh, that sounds a lot worse than the first thing.
It's not as bad as it sounds, guys.
I put my ear on his chest to see if I can hear a heartbeat.
Yeah, you can hear a heartbeat.
You guys just see Shaken limp into the room and then
so,
fall face first.
So Duramon's not corrupted, it just made him weird.
Oh, alright.
Yeah. But
it's weird how awesome I am.
Do you have any of those orbs that are like not corrupt? Like, an orb called the Inspiration or something like that.
Why don't you try using this one too? It feels great.
Nah.
I mean, okay.
If it was a hammer. Maybe.
He puts his elbow on the table, and you see a gauntlet, and he just fists his hand to the point where you can just see the back of his hand, and there's just orbs, like, on the knuckles of it.
This is the pirate, right?
Yeah,
this is the pirate.
The pirate's name
is orbs.
So screwed.
Yeah, orb hand. Hand of orbs. Is that a magic item? The hand of orbs? What is that?
What do you got? Tell us about it.
There are five of the orbs I have collected during my journey. Corruption is one of them.
Is he missing one on his hand?
There are several other orbs that are out there. Most of them are dropped from enemies, but it depends on what type of enemy.
So there's not just... Humans. I'm sorry. So they're not just one of each orb? They're multiples?
There is normally one of each orb.
Uh-oh. So is he missing an orb from his hand, Liam?
Since we have the corrupted one? He has many. He gave you an extra.
Secondhand orbs.
Secondhand orbs.
Just imagine the Infinity Gauntlet, but not as powerful.
Okay.
My character's just passed out. On his chair.
Your character cast darkness on, madness on himself. Did you figure that out?
Oh, you gotta roll a D100, man.
Do I have to figure that out?
Figure it out.
I don't know how that works.
Roll a D100, I'll tell you what you do.
Go into the info tab, the compendium. I don't know if you guys have it, but if...
Yeah, we have it. It's up there.
56. You must use... his or her action each round to attack the nearest creature.
Cool.
It lasts for 1d10 minutes.
That'd be metagaming.
So I'm gonna attach you to my side, and I'm just gonna start biting trees.
Ow!
Hey!
Stop!
What's he?
He's hungry!
What's going on?
The
Heartless has cast madness on Duramon.
I don't feel like you're helping us right now,
what,
sir.
What did
I just get up and hold my gun?
Everything's fine.
Put the gun away. Put the gun away. We got this. We'll figure it out. You don't need to shoot him.
Pass out.
He just comes up behind
Andy.
God, that was close.
And grabs his head.
Whoa.
And you see
you
a light, and then he lets go, and Andy's character is all back to normal.
So did you know that was gonna happen?
Why'd you do that to him?
When you gave him the orb?
Why'd you disappear?
Okay, there you are.
Is it just like a... Was that a lesson? Did we learn something?
That was a nasty trick, and I don't like you.
You only got 95 mana now.
It was teaching you the importance of not to play with dark magic.
Why did you give it? I'm confused.
Didn't you just tell him that you... Oh, I gotcha. I get it. I get it.
These orbs are not an item to be messed with constantly.
Don't
you
use
must
the
give
light.
Each one a cooldown, or else they...
They what? Did you fall asleep, sir?
They get too warm? What?
You guys just seem shotgun, get up, grab his gun, and point it at Doraemon again.
No. He's good now. He's better. He's better.
And face plants on
his face. Use his glowy hand.
I feel like we're going to have to explain a lot of stuff to that guy.
So we're okay, so let me recap our journey. There's a boat. We're on it. You gave us some really nasty magic, and we're supposed to help you now. Is that right?
Yeah. More or less.
I mean, he took the corruption that off of Duramon.
I mean, he seems pretty trustworthy. I say let's do it.
Well, we're kind of on his boat, so we're kind of...
We always have a choice.
If the choice is swimming, I choose the boat.
I can float.
Good for you.
Rachel, Hargan looks at your dark sword.
Uh-huh.
The Oblivion.
Uh-huh.
And he says, that sword is also one of the few ones that are actually corrupted. Like the corruption, it has the power to turn you into a dark soul yourself.
Oh. But it probably does a lot of damage, right?
Yes, but the corrupted one will actually take control of you for a while.
And probably do a lot of damage and defeat all of my enemies and bring me great glory.
Yes.
Gives you diarrhea.
Oh, like after I'm done fighting, right? Like, not like after, it's okay.
You probably have to go swimming afterwards.
She puts it on her back.
The twins, as they're called, are very different weapons. With the fact that they are magical, they are not able to be sold, misplaced, or given away. They are bound to your spirit and until you are dead or unworthy of its power.
It's handy if you lose your keys a lot.
I once lost the keys to my house, but I lived in an igloo. Go figure.
You bolted another door? Never mind.
No, I eventually got inside. It just turned out I didn't actually have keys.
So, is mine cursed? Good. I'm going to put my hammer on the table.
Your hammer is one of the few that are enchanted with godly powers.
Yes!
Like evil godly powers or just normal godly powers?
Just godly powers.
You guys just see me get up and put my head
down. Enchanted with Boston's powers. See what I did there?
Yeah.
And plop. You guys just see me put my head through the door and then fall to the ground.
I mean, do you have a medic on the boat? I feel like he needs help.
No, I think he's fine.
I think he's dying. Let's just throw him overboard.
I mean, okay.
I just get up, go into the room, and pull out my gun at him.
No.
Oh, he's not dead.
And then smash my head through the wall.
I think that's just how he says hi to people.
I just imagine him looking like this.
We can't see you. I'm sure whatever you're doing is really funny.
He's just holding a gun. He's like half asleep.
All right.
Yeah, I'm like sleepwalking.
So, what are the godly powers, or do I just have to kind of swing the hammer to find out?
Just
swing the hammer and find out.
I don't like that.
Now we feast.
Oh, yeah. I've already been eating this whole time.
On ham and salad.
I haven't eaten.
Who ate my ham and salad?
I ate it. You were taking your time.
I haven't eaten anything.
The
first
was a vegetarian.
Oh, is this not lettuce?
This isn't vegetarian ham.
Owlbear won't mind.
I will eat my dinner feast.
So,
it's just like food on a plate that I haven't even touched.
There's also, so as you start to dig into your food, there's water that you feel on your feet.
What?
Is there a whole
boat? Roll for
I don't feel anything. I'm sick. But I'm...
Alright, how do I select? I have to select my icon.
I rolled a 5.
And then hit initiative.
Nice.
I did it. I'm in the turn order.
Initiative 14.
I'm sorry, did I also see a random... Oh, yep, there's a crab. Okay.
Hey.
That's a big crab.
That's our dinner getting away.
Dead crab. You know what crabs hate? Hammers.
Click the initiative instead of just rolling a d20.
I had an 18. Put it back in.
I got a 14.
I also had a 10.
I had a rock.
10.
Dane had 10.
I think I put it in. I think I did it.
I had 14.
Andy had 6.
Yep.
14. Yes.
Okay, so up now is tree in the woods.
No one really
sees anything.
So just the water.
You all know that it's water.
Hey,
I'm still asleep.
Pirate Pete, Bill,
Kane, Mr. Kane, Kurgan Kane.
Mrs. Kane, there's some water in your boat.
Mister.
And I jump over the table, and I look around.
I'm stumped just now.
Do I notice anything?
There we go. Then I... Finn's like face down in the water.
No, my face is through the wall.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Yeah, you realize the Tom Finn's like napping in the water.
That's
you can't really see anything else other than water, and Tom Finn's like asleep in the water.
Good.
My face is in this hallway. I smashed my face.
It's good. It's good.
I'm heavier than you think.
That's my turn then. My
total weight 56.5.
Four. Oh my god, that's so dragonborn so heavy.
Sorry, Richard.
Alright, Rachel.
I mean, it is plus the chainmail.
I am going to shout, I smell danger! And I'm gonna run.
That was a weird way. That was a weird exit.
Also, if you go in the hallway, you'll see my face.
Okay, I see your face.
You are in the
I'm
hallway.
Gonna. Yep. I move. Can I see the
this hallway.
Crab through that door? Is this door closed? Is this door closed?
No. You can go through those doors. And yes,
you're right here. Yeah.
I'm gonna shout, you got a giant crab on your ship, you want me to shoot it?
Fire right. I suggest you try your new weapons. They would come in handy at a time like this.
So you seem like...
Yeah, one of them's really evil.
So you seem overly calm?
Yes.
I don't like that at all.
Okay, no,
he's an experienced fighter.
No, he brought this crab on board so we could fight it.
Oh.
I'm gonna use the.
I don't trust him.
I'm gonna use the Light Requiem.
I usually trust everyone.
And I'm gonna shoot the Light Requiem gun at
Requiem
the crab.
Of life.
My mama don't like him, and she likes everyone.
Else.
Mama don't like him.
Oh, nay, nay.
Does an 8 hit?
No.
Does a 15 hit?
Yes.
12 damage. So Liam, the healing on the light gun, do I like shoot people with it? Do I stab them with it? How does the healing work?
No, you like hold, you like... I'm gonna say you like knight them with it and it heals them.
Okay.
But that's also kind of weird.
Sure. How often can I do that?
Ten times per rest.
Okay.
Decent. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Decent.
It's an action. I'm assuming it's an action to do that.
Okay.
That's my turn.
Alright, shotgun, you have your face in the wall.
I wake up and smash the entire wall. I'm up. Do I see this crap over here?
Yeah. It's okay, he's got insurance.
I'm up.
So, I'm gonna like shimmy over here and say to the pirate guy, I hope you got more insurance. And I shimmy back over and shoot. Blue lightning. But I move over here and then roller. I need to move farther than that. Move over. Yeah. Good. Yeah, I can hit him.
Okay.
Here, see, I can hit him.
You shoot him?
I'm gonna shoot him with blue lightning. So
blue lightning is your effect.
He needs to roll a DC save with 11.
He's shooting with lightning.
Do?
Deep blow? You got the new weapon, the death penalty.
Oh yeah.
Deep blow.
I know, I'm not gonna use it now.
Deep blow.
That's Final Fantasy.
Okay. So he needs to roll DC save higher than 11.
Bless you again.
Bless you.
Bless you. Yeah, I didn't hear what you said.
Ten. He fails, so.
That's alright.
How much damage?
You're saying so many clever things, Andy, I can't hear you.
How much damage?
Sneeze, God bless you. I feel like that was fake. Is that fake, Rachel?
No, that was real. He's got bad allergies.
Dex save.
I'm sorry.
He's just saying the name of our group. What was the name of our group again?
So, how much damage does he take?
Sometimes after he sneezes a bunch, Danica starts pretending to sneeze.
2d6.
Dad, how much?
2d6.
Okay. 2d6. Pow, pow. 6 damage.
Should have done the death. Rachel, you also got, like, 5 charge points for killing the boss.
Oh.
Oh, yeah! Would I get 5 charge points for that?
DM
yeah,
said
she was a boss that took.
Oh, my gauntlet is full!
Did you do the damage? You aren't making
yes,
the.
Yes, I did.
Thing.
No, that was. Honest, that was when I GM rolled.
I'm the dungeon master. I control worlds, universes! Every potion you drank, I mixed it!
Alright.
Every magic item you find, I put it there!
And. I mean, Dane.
Yes. Yeah, I'm gonna hammer that crab. I'm gonna make some crab soup.
It's gonna take you like 80
just
turns.
Just a disclaimer, there are walls.
No, there's
go
a
through
hole
the wall
right
that,
here.
Yeah, can you go through the wall that Tom's faster? What is going on? Why am I... No, that's not where I moved. I'm sorry.
That's a wall.
I can't remember how to click, but there's a thing here.
There's a wall.
Dane, why do I keep saying Andy?
Wall.
You know who you are.
I'll go
I feel
here,
like he broke a pretty good hole there.
Yeah.
Alright, I'm against the wall, not through the wall. Just to know. And then I'm going to take another move.
That's the hole he broke.
Here. And here. And then here. Behind Tom. And that's my turn, I guess.
Like, are you sure you want to stand behind the Dragonborn... who just woke up, who's also holding a gun.
Well, he's shooting it the other way, isn't he? I mean, he's not shooting it my way.
I literally just shot lightning
through the door. Are you spinning around shooting stuff?
All right, Andy.
Because if you are, then yeah, maybe I'll be worried.
Here, I'll check.
Okay, yeah, see? That's good. Shoot it that way.
It's your turn, Andy.
This is how I shot. So, some things show power.
I'll move up here.
You gonna use the summon? Okay, cool.
Totally gonna get real tight real fast.
DM says
Lame,
I use the summon.
Lame, don't forget about Andy's
weapon. I don't know.
No, it's just...
And you can make him roll on the wild magic chart.
Oh yeah, because that counts as a different type of magic.
I mean, I've been casting all kinds of spells. I will cast a spell.
Summon spells.
You cast fireball. Middle of the ship, cast some fireball.
I'm sure it'll be fine.
Do not cast it on me and Andy.
Stone.
Because I am still
the
freaking
thing,
out.
The DC 15 dexterity saving
throw. Shotgun will still.
Tom, you can't talk over other players, dude.
Yep. Me too.
Plus 15.
Yeah, because he's wet.
Oh. Okay. Alright.
So it takes half damage, so 12 damage. It's my turn.
Alright. Now it's time for the king. I have to remember what I actually... This is info, NPCs.
So we're at 10, 11.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah, I was gonna see if this battle takes a longer time. If not, we're gonna... call it here soon.
Yeah, he's a big crab, so...
He's a big crab. We'll see what happens. Oh, I want to see what this guy does.
Here groaning, I'm just gonna do some stretches.
Swim is over, so he's not covering Dane.
Oh.
So you watch Leon pull, flip his like robe-ish type thing to the side, and there's a little gun, and he pulls it up, and he's gonna shoot at it.
He's got a little gun.
Nice.
Pew pew.
This guy's the top of the leaderboard.
Look out.
Rolled a 7 though. I mean, the pirate captain's gotta be level 20, right? You can just take him out.
Alright.
That's a better roll.
It pays to be the captain, I say.
Five.
What's he attacking with?
A gun. So you all notice that Hannah Kane is trying to get to her workshop in the back, and that Leon and Hargan are trying to like protect her so she can get there.
Interesting. Oh, hey there, big crab.
Is big crab.
Tom, I think you have a space in there that's messing up your roll there, buddy.
What?
Yeah, so you put rolling 20 space d20, so it only really rolled 1.
And it made it a nat 20.
No, I did rolling 20d20 to make it because I did that before. So it made it so I would roll a 20.
Oh, because you're a cheater. Does crab attack us yet?
He's dang Tom. This is an 8-hit toss.
I just go, nah, you can't hit me because I'm so fast. And I just plop to the ground to sleep and then get back up. In like 5 seconds. I would say 2 minutes, I get back up.
And then, Thomas, his other claw grabs you and you become grappled.
Oh, snap!
Okay, hold on. Take these off.
Yeah, actually put the real one on.
So when you are grappled, you have to roll on your turn a DC save.
Somebody just fireball this guy again.
And then it is back to tree.
Dexterity save, Lynn.
All right, so Liam, I say we do one more round, and then we'll pause. Okay.
Okay.
All right. So tree in the woods.
What do I need to do?
On your turn, you can worry about it.
Okay.
Okay, so you're grappled. On your turn, we'll worry about grappled. So tree in the woods, can run through. You know what? I'm gonna go through this door correctly. Excuse me. So that's 40.
I love
and then I'll use my feline craziness. And I'm gonna flip over top of this crab. I can actually go 4/8. I can go 120 feet in one turn, but I'm not going to. I don't need to.
Just slice his arm off.
However, I'm gonna attempt to like jump over the crab. So I'm gonna roll an acrobatics.
You can also yeah.
10 succeed.
10 succeeds, but...
Oh, yeah. But?
You take damage from stepping on one of his spikes.
Ah, don't touch it!
Grab spikes.
And then I'm gonna... Quarterstaff! Claw!
You also have the Ring of Finger Guns?
I did until I shot 3 times before this battle. So,
just to show us how it worked.
Yeah, I only get 3, so. Whoops. I'm like.
Well, in my defense, I feel like the summoning tutorial went quite well.
I think, yeah. Hmm? Quarterstaff! Yes. Unarmed!
That hits.
Did both of those hit?
The last 2 hit, yeah.
Yeah.
Last 2 hit.
Yeah.
Did I really only roll 4?
And I'm gonna try a stunning strike. So I'm gonna spend one of my key points I got left, and you gotta make a constitution save.
Add your modifier.
Check on his butt. Roll 212. Does that it?
100,000 feet.
That's about fart. It does 145.
Okay, Tom, stop rolling in chat when it's not your turn. Did he make a roll, Liam?
Hold on, I'm trying to read his stats.
Okay, I believe it's Constitution. I burped.
That was a butt roll that much. I rolled 15.
Rolled a 15. I think that succeeds. I don't think mine. Yeah.
Okay, that's my turn.
I probably should just blow my last key point, but whatever.
Right. Rachel.
Pew pew.
You have a special gun sword.
Use a special gun sword.
I do.
I feel like that DM wants you to use it.
I'm trying to introduce you all to your special weapon.
The thing is, it doesn't deal any more damage than my regular gun sword, and if I roll poorly, it gets really bad.
It's probably fine.
It's insanely good if you roll really bad.
What's the worst that could happen?
Can murder all of you.
That's pretty bad.
I mean, I'd like to see you try. My armor class is 15.
Mine's is 20.
Yeah, and like,
it can deal up to 100 damage.
You could.
I'm gonna do it.
Why are you swinging
the
sword?
It would be a fitting way to end the campaign.
Yep.
I'm glad they put the disclaimers on this thing.
Alright, it doesn't say that. It says that it's made out of pure evil. Charisma save.
Oh, you have to make a Christmas save.
I have to make a Christmas save,
oh,
not.
No.
You got this, you got this, you got this.
Yep, okay. Oh, sure, that's
did you make
great.
It? Did you make it?
My heart becomes swallowed in darkness.
Okay.
I become a dark sprite.
Okay.
And now I roll a D100.
So far, so good. 73. Sure, that's fine.
She still controls her character.
Okay. So you're an evil dark sprite who controls her character?
So now I can attack with the Heartless? I can attack the demon in attack, or do I just use the sword damage?
Now she's uncovered.
You use the demon attack.
Okay.
Don't draw or delete that.
Nene turns into a dark sprite who is made out of pure evil. I am swallowed in darkness, and she shrieks in rage and fury and agony. And holds out her hand towards the crab and sends pure evil flying at it.
Hey, what's happening back there? Like? I can't see it.
And I deal 21 damage.
What?
That go?
Of evil.
Hey, am I on grapple? Thanks.
No.
Shush.
You should.
Yeah, it's not your turn. Be quiet.
21 for 5d6 damage. Not feeling bad about this.
Do I make that D100 roll every round, or just when I first fail?
Sure.
Sure.
Okay, that's my turn.
Okay. It's time to check in with my favorite, sleeping, grappled, butt-rolling dragonborn.
That's a 222.
Okay, so Tom, are you ready? Speed is now zero, and you cannot benefit from whatever. Condition ends, blah, 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 blah. So I'm pretty sure it's a...
Can't move.
You'd have to use your turn to try to break free the grapple, or you can just attack him while being grappled, but you can't move.
Can I fart?
You could, but it's not going to do any damage.
No, I haven't used shotguns, but...
Are you attacking? Then...
Yeah. Let's use my
I'm glad that he's learning how to make weapons in this game. Even if it is this weakness that he keeps rolling.
I'm gonna use gun mastery with my caster, so if I get a 10 minus, it says all guns attack. You can't miss. If you roll a 10 minus at your gun, it was jammed. Yes, Lam did write that. So, let's go ahead and add that to the chat for ya.
All guns attack. Attacks can't miss.
Okay, so that hits Tom.
Do I get to do it again or twice?
There was a death blow effect, I'm pretty sure.
D-blow?
D-blow. Yeah.
That was like crit at 17 plus.
And I'm using God Master, so yeah, I did it!
Okay.
Roll your damage.
Damage.
Roll your butt.
Damn.
Nice.
And then I roll my butt.
Alright, Tom, no more of those.
Okay.
You're clogging up the chat.
I love that it reaches 100,000 feet. That's quite useful.
Yeah, I'll blow up this old ship.
Tom, are you shooting again?
Shoot with my musket.
I gave you a special
D-blow! That's a 27.
27 hit? 24. Oh, okay. So 24
hits.
Yeah.
When attacking with a normal bullet, you crit at 17 plus. Critical damage!
Did he roll a 17?
Here, I'll show you D-blow.
No, he rolled a...
24.
He rolled a 16.
I rolled a 24.
No, he rolled an... Yeah, he rolled an 18. Yeah, he rolled an 18, so with death blow, he crit.
Yep, okay.
So,
crit it up. Just roll and we'll double it. Roll your damage. Ooh. So, it's 16 plus 3, 19. 19 damage.
Is it dead yet?
I don't know. Is it? It might be when it gets a concussion from Dane's hammer.
Here come the hammers.
But you just see me.
What's your hammer's name? Daffodil and Dolores?
Well, I got a new hammer now. I haven't named it yet.
When my turn ends, I just go, it's like, yeah, 10 CP forward, and like inside. A spooky sound, and then I just face plant on his claw.
Oh, nice.
And just, like, no, start that crab.
No.
The Hammer of the Stars! Is 8 good enough?
8 is not.
Oh no. Can hit again with the Hammer of the Stars?
Hammer of the Betsy. I think I only have. Do I have an extra attack? Did that hit the guy?
12, yes.
Alright. Good old Betsy. And they're one damage. That's it for me.
Good job there, Betsy. You did a real good job.
Good job.
Well, use the demon staff.
Yeah.
No. No.
Tom.
Liam, remember why
Thomas.
Magic.
Thomas.
I did it.
12. I actually remember what 12.
Did you roll something?
Did.
No.
He GM'd rolled, so only I.
Oh.
That would be DM will tell.
Yeah! So, Andy, you take damage equal to the amount of damage that it would take to knock you down to 1 HP, and the enemy takes the damage the health that you lost.
Oh. I mean, that sucks, but that's also kind of cool.
No, it attacks. It attacks with the health that you lost.
So he's doing the amount of damage that he lost to the crab?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I lose 30 hit points.
Oh, that's pretty sweet, actually. Thomas.
So other than being basically annihilated, how do you do it?
I'm on ground.
Tom.
Blood pours out of my nose, but it's really acid blood. And I say, the power of the dragons will destroy you. That's it.
And then
crab drops to the floor. It is dead. Water is rushing in. Hannah looks at you all and as she's running past and says, quick, get in the mech. And she gets in.
You mean their tank?
No, the mech. The mech.
I get in that mech.
Yeah, I get in.
Yeah, get in.
I'm surprised you didn't make this boat to be crab-proof. This feels like a technical oversight.
Only the black box is crab-proof.
Is your dad, Uncle Bob?
Andy, are you getting in the back?
Yeah, sure.
Because this is the way.
This is the way.
This is the way.
You guys sit right there.
So, as you all flee in the mech, you realize that Targan stayed behind. As you resurface to try to get Hargan on, he says, go on without me. The captain always goes down with the ship.
Oh.
And he throws the map at you, Rachel.
I mean, I feel like there was enough room in the ship, but okay.
Can I have the sword back too, please? You said it was the key
to
the treasure.
And he throws it was wrapped in the map.
Wait a minute. This guy looks different. I can't. Quick. Though.
Okay. I have the Sword of Heroes and a map.
Goodbye, nice. Harmond.
I think he'll be fine. He said he's the ship captain. And boat.
It was an honor sailing with you, sir.
I think where'd he left? I think he drowned.
No. Well, sorry.
So as Hannah manages to pilot you all through the deep ocean, you all see through the windows a island up ahead. She surfaces the mech and lands on it. You all get out, and there's just wreckage all over the beach of what you think to be the ship.
Oh, I just get in the wreckage. Like this pile.
Oh, this little pile right here. I was like, where are you talking?
Yeah. Wait, I can't click.
Okay, that is a good stopping point.
Yeah. I was going to say that's where we're going to end.
All right.
We will figure out a time we can play.
Thanks for running, Liam.
Yeah,
I have a sword of heroes and an evil sword.
I have figure guns. But right now they're just
click 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 click.
They're empty. Awesome. That was fun, Liam. Good job.
Thanks, Liam.
Thank you.
Thanks for running.